Hi everyone, welcome to Introduction to Computer. I hope you enjoyed the last animation video of Introduction to Computer. In this video, we are going to talk about some of the details of the computer. So first of all, what is a computer? After watching our animation video, you should know that it is a programmable machine. And it is capable of processing informations. And it can perform computations by using a set of instructions. Okay. And now let's talk about some little history of the computers. The concept of the computers, concept of this programmable machine, first introduced in the 19th century. Okay. But of course, it wasn't until the mid-20th century that the computers began to take shapes in their modern form. The first computer was invented in the 1940s. But as you can see in the image, it was too large. The first computers, they were too large and too expensive. Okay. Therefore, it was primarily used for military and scientific purposes. And then later on, during 50s to 60s, computer technology continued to evolve. During those times, computers started to be used in the businesses and the governments. Okay. And then during 70s to 80s, we saw the rise of the personal computers, because during that time, the Apple II and IBM personal computers were introduced. Okay. And then from 90s to 2000s, the internet came along. From 1990s to 2000s, internet came along. And it revolutionized the computing. It was a game changer. And today computers continue to evolve at the rapid pace because technologies are evolving too. Okay? And the types of the computers. Well, there are several different types of computers. Each type has the different size, design, and purposes. Okay? The most familiar one, the one that is most common and familiar to everyone, is the personal computers. I'm sure you have interacted with the personal computers. Okay? The personal computers, it includes the desktops, laptops, and mainly designed for personal use. And besides the personal computers, the other type of computers that you must know as a programmer, as a IT professional, is the servers. Okay, servers are the powerful computers that is designed to provide services to other computers over a network. You may have heard of Amazon Web Servers, Google Servers, Microsoft Servers. Okay. Those companies, they have their own servers and they provide services to other computers through their networks. Okay? And besides the servers, we also have the workstations. So the workstations, they are the high performance computers. They have the highest high performance and they are designed for professionals such as engineers and scientists. Okay? And besides the workstations, we also have mainframes. Okay, mainframes. They are also large computers, and they are large and powerful. They are designed to handle the massive amount of data and perform the complex applications. Okay, they are commonly used in the large organizations and government agencies, basically, the mainframes. And besides mainframes, yes, as you can see here, we have variable computers and embedded computers. They are the small size computers. The variable computers are the computers that you can wear on your body. And embedded computers, they are the computers that are integrated into other devices, such as cars, okay, and also the home appliance and medical equipment. And then lastly, we also have the supercomputers. The name itself, it should tell you about this type of computers, okay? So the supercomputers, they are known as the most powerful computers in the world right now, okay? With the highest processing speed and storage capacity. They are used for the scientific simulations, weather forecasting, and also besides the weather forecasting, like it's also used for other complex applications. Okay, they are the most powerful computers in the world, the supercomputers. So those are the different types of computers. But make sure that you are familiar with the PC, and make sure that you also know what servers are. Those two types of computers, they are important to know. Okay. And next, let's talk about the basic functions of the computers. So the very basic functions of the computer is to take the data, which is also known as the input, okay? To take the data, and besides the data, it can also take instructions. You can also give instructions as an input. The data and instructions can be taken as an input to the computer, okay? And then this computer, it processes the data afterwards. It processes data as per instructions, okay? And then it is going to display the output, or it can also store the data, okay? So it is display and store the data, store the processed data afterwards. That's the basic functions of the computer. And those functions are also known as the input function, as you can see here, input function, okay? This is one. And the process function, this is second function, output function, and storing function, storage function. So those are the four basic functions of the computer, okay? And to provide those functions, a computer uses its components, okay? It uses its components and devices. Usually, components of the computer are designed to perform only one or two of those functions. Not all, only one or two, okay? Those basic functions of the computer, it enables the computer to perform a wide range of tasks, okay? Such as word processing that you might be familiar with, and multimedia editing, web browsing, gaming, and many more, okay? So those are the basic functions of the computer. And the next is the components of computers. So in our animation video, we stated that the hardware and software are the important components of the computer, okay? Those are the two components of the computer. They both are essential for the computer to operate the computer, okay? And those components, they cannot be exist without another. We also stated that in the animation video. In our next videos, we will be talking about the hardwares and then softwares. We will talk about the details of those components of the computers. See you all in the next video.